I'm Michelle. Welcome back to my channel. Today is the first day of the Winter Biannual Bibliothon. I absolutely love the video challenges that we get to do each week. I can't think of it off the top of my head who the host for today's challenges, but I will leave the link below. So the first challenge is the Where's Waldo challenge. For this challenge, you are supposed to take a scene of a story and rewrite it without the main protagonist or without the main character. Unfortunately, I'm not a writer, y'all, and I could not find a way to completely eliminate the main character. I guess I'm just not creative like that. So I have redone the story of Hush Hush, or a part of the story Hush Hush. Hush Hush is the first in a series of 4 books. So anyways, I hope you really enjoy my retelling of Hush Hush.
This is Patch. He was once an angel, but he messed up somehow, and they cut off his wings. He fell to Earth, where he's condemned to an eternity where he can't feel anything, like on his skin. Likely any emotions as well. Now he just hangs out in a dank, smoky pool hall or bar, playing pool. Patch can either live for eternity on Earth, brooding and playing pool, or kill someone to become human. So he can hang out, play pool until he dies, maybe from lung cancer. Or he can convince someone to sacrifice themselves for him so he can become a guardian angel. Not likely. He's not very charming. Decisions. So he decides to kill somebody. So he enrolls in high school because teenagers suck. Should be easy, and apparently this is the only place to find them. After a year of brooding in the back of the class, where it seems he was basically invisible the whole year, the teacher assigns a ridiculously cliche and highly inappropriate assignment in, of course, biology, pairing boys and girls up in groups to discuss mating. Wow, what a way to get kids thinking about sex and ignoring the, teen pregnancy? Seriously, what's this teacher's damage? Patch got paired with V. Yeah, I don't know, as in Victoria, Vixen, Virgin, whatever. Not that Patch is much better. V is notorious for trying too hard, because every YA has one of those. That girl with no shame in her game. She relentlessly flirts, batting her eyelashes, flipping her hair, wearing skippy clothes, obsessing about her cleavage, and thinks that she knows what all guys want. Patch is not impressed. V can't believe what Patch's problem must be. She's determined to seduce him and dreams up a slew of dramatic schemes to woo him, to no avail. One day, she introduces Patch to her friend Nora. And oh my gosh. Patch reacts with a crooked smile. He must find plain Jane Nora attractive. What? B decides to tell her Goody Two Shoes friend that he's bad news and he's dangerous. Honestly, it didn't take much. Nora's a spaz. Patch tries to give Nora his phone number. Of course, Nora, listening to her friend, says she would never, ever call him. And yet, for reasons unknown, Nora follows Patch to a bar, where she waltzes in and nobody questions why underage teenagers are at a bar. Patch teaches Nora to play pool, where they banter about mating, biology, and how Nora hates Patch yet follows him around. And that was it. That was all it took. Nora was in love. Well, he's just as boring, if not more so, than Nora. I guess it makes sense. No, wait. Nora's instincts tell her that Patch wants to kill her until she sees his face, and she loves him again. Yeah, it just keeps going on this way. Wait, this is a story about fallen angels. Not Nora's mental health, which should be checked. So Patch, who doesn't really do anything, finally has had enough. He decides that Nora is a crazy loon, and he would be doing the world a service to sacrifice her life and become human. Oh yeah, and Patch has a friend that's also a fallen angel, comes to congratulate Patch for becoming a human. The end. Although Patch wasn't the most exciting character, he still makes a better human than Nora. And he suggests to his friend that he go ahead and take care of V so that he can become human too, because V is a pretty miserable human being as well. Brilliant idea! I do believe that this story has a much better ending now.